We're making treasure chests today. Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions. So you can either decorate it when it's made, or what I'm gonna do is while it's still flat.
But I won't know what place is what.
That's true. If you wanna see how your treasure chest fits together, you can fold it first, but I'm gonna decorate mine while it's flat, because I'm just gonna kind of decorate it brown. You can use whatever crayons or markers you want to use. So I am just gonna kind of make it all a kind of woodsy brown scribble. Okay, Claire, while you're decorating and I'm decorating, I'm gonna read the gospel to you. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share my inheritance with me." Does that sound like you sometimes? Mom and Dad, tell Dominic to give this to me. You ever say stuff like that?
Yeah.
So somebody did that to Jesus. And you know what Jesus said?
What?
He replied to them, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbiter?" Do you know what that means?
Nope.
Judge and like lawyer, the person arguing on your behalf. Then he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions." But he's talking about don't just worry about getting money in life. Don't just worry about getting stuff. It's not just about toys. And what's a better way to be?
Maybe we have that toy and we might be able to share it also.
Yeah, and maybe what should you value?
The friend or the brother or sister.
Very good, Claire. So Jesus told them a parable like he likes to do. He says, there was a rich man whose land produced a bountiful harvest. And he asked himself, "What shall I do? For I do not have space to store my harvest." And he said, "This is what I shall do. I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I should store up all my grain and other goods. And I shall say to myself, now as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, and be merry." But God said to him, "You fool, this night your life will be demanded of you, and the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong?"
Wait, thus, who will they? I don't.
He's saying, hey, if you just, this guy didn't have like kids to leave stuff to. He was just like, I just want it all for myself. I'm gonna save up all my stuff. And God says then, what good does that do? Basically, can you take your stuff with you when you die, Claire?
No. Well, or you can just bury, you can ask someone to bury it with you.
But can you use it when you're dead?
No.
Yeah, that's the point. You can't use it when you're dead. But people sometimes want to just store all their stuff up. And he says, thus it will be for all who store up treasure for themselves, but are not rich in what matters to God. And I'm going to fold my box now.
Oh, I could do it for you. So I'm just folding these two flaps in. I can just go like that. And these two stay in, this goes in also. So there's a nice bottom on the inside. And it's kind of like that one with the medical kit, but this goes in and goes down like this. So it's flat inside. This is the lid and hold it. And down.
Mm-hmm. So we fold on our edges and then it can pop in to close. Teamwork.
Oh, these flaps go in, but this comes out. Yep. Stays out.
So there's the bottom and there's the top. Thanks for your help, Claire. So once you've assembled your box, we're going to use four stickers on the inside to keep the lid together. So we're gonna use our clear stickers. And we're gonna remember that we're storing up treasure for heaven by the nice things that we do and by prioritizing God. So maybe we could make notes of things that we've done that are nice and good and put those in here. Or we could use this to store up riches to go and take to church, like so when there's the collection.
Yeah.
There are other ways that you could donate money so that it can be of use today. It's up to you how you decorate your box. But once you have it assembled, you can see you could cut your ribbon in half and you could make like two straps. You could glue coins on, like in the example. And these are self-adhesive gems that you can use to decorate it. Claire, how can we grow in generosity instead of greed?
By giving up lots of stuff that we have and not just keeping it all to ourselves, then make a habit of giving other people some stuff that they want and you have, and not just be greedy and just take the stuff that they want, but not be like the Grinch. And if you want something, you can just give it up if other people need it.
Yeah, and that's a way we can store up our riches in heaven, to be generous. And what do you think God wants us to be like?
Not the Grinch, I know that.
Yeah, so I cut my strap in half. Now I'm gonna look at how long I need for the front.
Got to there.
So we so don't have it. That glue problem.
Uh-huh. I'll put some glue on the side I want for down here. Then I wanna glue this right here, because I like the way that looks with the strap, but I'm not gluing over where it seals. Make sure you leave it open to dry so you don't accidentally glue your treasure chest shut. High five.